This is a video tutorial for the Conservation Momentum worksheet. The first one we'll talk about is page 1, which is questions, examples, or exercises 1 through 4, and it talks about elastic collisions. And with elastic collisions, the idea here is that we are going to bounce, and if it's perfectly elastic, you will have a perfect bounce, 100% of the momentum will be transferred. It's true that if there's any deformation or smashing, it won't be perfectly elastic. And you will lose some of the idea, some of the momentum will not be conserved, it will go into the crash. So anyway, this is a perfect bounce, and everything on this worksheet refers to the perfect bounce, or the perfectly elastic collision. And the other one, the inelastic, is going to be sticking together. So what this shows here, and the way I want you to look at this, is that momentum is P equals MV. And if you can just kind of realize that the mass is just the object itself, and the velocity is if the object is moving, and that is really the definition of momentum. So here, the scenario goes like this. I have an object that's moving toward another object, and the other object may be moving or not. And I'm going to draw it as a square just to make sure that you see that they're different. And this is before they collide. So then what we do is we say, okay, bam, they're going to collide. And after they collide, they're going to bounce off each other. So maybe this one goes this way, and maybe this one goes the other way. I don't know exactly where they're going, but I do know that they're not stuck together. They are bouncing off of each other. And so this is them after. And mathematically speaking, you can put ones and zeros to describe it. The subscripts 1 and 2 refer to the objects 1 and 2 respectively. But instead of that, we can just draw it. So for instance, I can say object number 1 has a mass and a velocity. And then object number 2 also has a mass and a velocity. And then they collide. And then object number 1 is going to go backwards in this case. And object number 2 is going to go forward. So mathematically speaking, we can simplify this writing here by adding the picture along with it. If you don't have the picture along with it, then you'll need to explain this stuff. So this is why the numbers are there, because there's no picture. But when we have the picture, we don't need the numbers. So look in the first one, we got Tubby and Chubby inside of this cart. And so this is our mass of Chubby, Tubby, and the cart. And they have a velocity. And then we have little Melinda inside of her cart. And she has a littler mass with a whatever the velocity is. And then once again, afterward, we have Chubby and Tubby together inside of a cart. And we have Melinda inside of her cart. So I haven't really added any details yet. That's the next step. So the first step is to draw the scenario, and the second step is to add the equation. And now the substitution is where the real physics comes in, so you can see what you're doing where. So the question is saying, how fast is Melinda's car bumped? So this is what we want to find out, and it's that V. So V is what we're going to solve for right there. So these are the things that we do know right now. We know that Chubby plus Tubby plus the cart is 300 kilograms, 100 plus 100 plus 100. And we know the velocity of Chubby, Tubby, and the cart is, so it's 200 plus 100 is 300, and their velocity is 10 meters per second. Okay, and then we have Melinda. And Melinda is 100 for the cart plus 25. So she's 125. And she's not moving, so she's zero. That's before. And so in the before, we're going to make a line right there to say before and after. And then we have, on this side, we have 300, Chubby, Tubby, and the cart. I'm trying to keep it uniform with respect to colors here. So 300 is Chubby, Tubby, and the cart. And it says that afterward, they are going from 10, now they're going 4.12. And then finally, little Melinda is still 125. And so we solve for V here. So we have, and I'll go all, maybe I'm not going to follow the colors too well here. We have 3,000 plus 0 equals 300 plus, or 300 times 4.12, I'm trying to get it all in a time, is 100 and, or 1236 plus 125. V. And so as you go through here, we're just going to solve for V.